So guys, once again, welcome back to Ahoy Navigos. Today we are back with our chart work concepts. Today we are going to discuss about some basic and important concepts. Those are allowing and counteracting methods, how to allow and counteract a wind and a current. So let us look into it. First important term we want to discuss is leeway. So let us know what is leeway. Leeway is nothing that is just the effect of wind on your heading. You're heading some way and there will be an effect if there is a wind, that is called as your leeway. Second term is, what is current? Current is nothing. This is the movement of seawater generated by a number of forces acting upon water like wind, Coriolis effect, waves, temperature and salinity differences. So these factors can affect the movement of seawater. This movement is what is called as current. Now let us know how we will name leeway and current. That is how we will name the wind and current. There is an easy concept that wind or leeway, that is always from where it is blown. That means from which direction the wind is blowing, that is where it is coming from, that is the direction of that wind. And current is always to where it is flowing. That means current is always named in the direction it is flowing, not from where it is coming, but in the direction where it is flowing. So for our easy remembrance, we have a quote that is, wind is always blows and current is flows. Wind is named from where it is blowing, and current is named from where it is flowing. So let us do some examples so you will get a better idea how to name. So we have current here and we have wind here. So let's give some directions. So let's see how we can name this current. This current is moving in this direction, and how we will name current is always flowing. That means this is flowing towards 090. So that is how we name that current. Similarly, if it's this way, it will be 270. If it is this way down, it will be 180. It's towards where it is flowing. So that means it's flowing towards 180. So this wind is named as 180. Similarly, it will be 000 in this direction, and it will be 045 in this direction. So it is flowing towards 045. That's why it's named 045. Similarly, it will be 225 in this case. So current is done. Now let us look into how wind is named with some examples. This direction, the current was, when it's flowing, it is 090. But in case of wind, it is blowing. That means in this direction, the wind will be 270 because it's coming from that side. So it is from where it is coming. So exactly this will be opposite. The direction naming of current and wind is exactly opposite. You have this direction as 090, you have this direction as 000, you have this direction as 180, you have this direction as 225, and your last, when it is moving like this, it is from where it is blowing, so this is 045. So this is how you name the current and wind. Now let us look into what is allowing case and counteracting case. So this is allowing. So let us look into it. The main thing that you need to remember when you go ahead with an allowing case is that you need to apply your leeway first, and then you need to apply your current. This is the basic concept of allowing case. If you apply current first and then leeway, you will get wrong. So the first thing you need to apply is leeway and then current. The main concept is that in allowing case, you apply your current after you sail some distance. We will show you how it is done. Sail some distance, that means you had already experienced the leeway, so you will be applying your current after that. So that means you apply leeway first because you already sailed, and current. So let us look into it. Given data will be course to steer, engine speed, set and rate. And what you need to find from these kinds of questions are CMG, that is your course made good. So for example, we have a set and rate of 150 into 3 knots for the example purpose. So you have an initial fix over here. So let us see. suppose this is your CTS. So this is your CTS. There is nothing without your leeway. That is just your initial CTS. And let us see. Now we have a wind from here that is northwesterly into 3 degrees that we have a leeway. So in allowing case, we apply the leeway first. So to your CTS, if you experience a leeway like this, you will be having a heading more down. So that will be something like this. So it is 3 degrees you have. So this will be your CTS due to your wind. And now if you cut your engine speed for 1 hour on this CTS due to wind, you will be reaching at a point called as your DR wind, because you are experiencing wind and you are reaching some point that is called your DR wind. Now what next to do is we need to apply your set and rate. So this distance is nothing but that is your engine speed for 1 hour, what you cut over here. If you apply your current to that point, will be somewhat like this, 150 current, and you have, this is your set, and you have that distance. We need to mesh, we need to cut a distance that is for 1 hour, because we are constructing an equilateral triangle with all sides 1 hour. So this rate will be also for 1 hour. So rate for 1 hour, you cut it somewhere here like this. So you need to now join from your initial fix to your this point that is nothing but your CMG, that is your course made good. So guys, this is how you find course made good, and the position that you reach in that course made good, that will be your estimated position, that's your calculated position that you are supposed to reach. But in actual scenarios, this leeway and everything is not constant, it keeps changing. So there will be some difference between this estimated position and actual position. So this is how you deal with this allowing case. So guys, now let us go into counteracting case. The main concept to remember in counteracting case is here you apply current first and then leeway. In last case, it was leeway first, then your current. In this case, it is current first, then your leeway. I'll tell you how, why it is done. Because in counteracting case, you are applying your current at your initial point. We will see how it is. If you are applying your at your initial point, that means you haven't experienced your leeway. At that point, you will be experiencing your leeway only if you're sailing some distance. So if you're applying your current initially, you have no leeway that time. So you apply your current, you find your CTS. Then if you start sailing, you will be have to apply the leeway. So that's why here, current first, then your leeway. So let us look into it. You have an initial fix over here and you have a final fix over here. You should be having two fixes, because in this kinds of questions, what given data will be CMG. If you have initial fix and you have final fix, you will be getting your CMG from connecting them. They will give you set and rate. Also, they have to give you engine speed. So what you need to find in these questions are CTS. So for example, we take a set and rate of 130 into 3 knots and a leeway of northwesterly into 3 degrees. So now you have initial fix and final fix. Let us join them. That will be nothing but your CMG. Now, next thing what you need to do is you need to apply your current at initial point, because you are counteracting something. So you initially counteract it so that you reach your desired fixed final. So this is your 130 into 3 knots. You're counteracting the current. This is your set for 130 and you cut it for 1 hour, rate for 1 hour. That is 3 knots, and now this is your set and rate for 1 hour. From this point, now next what you need to do is that you need to apply your engine speed on your compass, and you need to cut that by pointing one side of the compass here, and you need to cut that engine speed on this CMG. It will be something like that. You need to cut. If you cut it like this, if you join these two lines, that is nothing but that is your CTS without wind. That is your CTS only with your current, that is only counteracting your current without wind. So now we have CTS without wind. Now you need to apply your leeway. Now you start sailing, so you need to apply your leeway, that is northwesterly into 3 degrees. So if you apply that, that will be, if you're having a current like this, northwesterly into 3, in allowing case, you are allowing the wind to deviate from your CTS. Now you are counteracting that so that you get your required CTS. So if you're counteracting, you should be counteracting to the side from which the wind is coming. So it will be somewhat like this. So this is your counteracting CTS. So this is your CTS. That 3 degrees you are counteracting, and this is your CTS counteracting both wind and your current. So guys, this is how you do with these kinds of problem. I hope you guys understood. Still, if you have some doubts, you can put in your comments. We will get to you. This is Ahoy Navigos.